This is the third part of the video. Here we'll be building the joystick robot, joystick controller robot. Let's see the assembly part of the joystick controller robot. We have already built the chassis in the second part. We'll go ahead and we'll build the robot. We have the joystick controller board, we have the receiver board, and apart from that we have the nuts, we have small screws, and we have the ET spacers, and your battery holder is already ready. The things that doesn't come in your package is the batteries. So you need a set of batteries, you need a 9 volts battery, and you need AA batteries. You need 8 AA batteries, one 9 volts battery. You need a small screwdriver to fix all your screws. So let me just brief you about how this joystick controller robot works. These two are the boards. The top one that you see is the transmitter board. This has a joystick mounted on it, and the bottom one is the receiver board. This works on a 434 megahertz transmitter receiver pair. So if you can see, this is the 434 megahertz receiver board, and on the transmitter board we have a 434 megahertz transmitter board. And while the joystick analog signals are given to the microcontroller, the microcontroller processes them and gives it to your RF encoder, that is HT12E, and then it is transmitted. The same signals are received in your HT12E, there's a receiver here, through your RF receiver module, and then it goes to the motor driver L293D. These motor drivers are connected to the motors. So all the microcontroller program is already programmed in such a way that when you push the joystick front, your robot will go front and back and then left and right. So for the people who have bought the boards with which are like completely DIY kit, there are few warnings which are mentioned clearly in the manual. Please go through the manual. Some of the warnings are the direction of your LEDs, direction of your ICs. The notch should be matching the same notch which is there on the your board, and even your direction of your RF module is very important, and your polarities of your diodes should be very accurate. For this RF transmitter receiver pair, we'll have to there are eight address bits in your transmitter. Whatever address bits you are set, the same thing should be set in your receiver board also. For example, here all the bits are low, so here also all the bits are low, only then they communicate. If I make one of the bit high, and here also I'll have to make one of the bit high, only then they'll communicate with each other and you can transmit. So this is basically done to avoid overlapping with two transmitter receiver pair. So in the next part, we'll just continue with mounting these boards, and we'll start doing the connections. And one more warning is that when you are doing a component soldering on the board, there might be some of the boards might have few wires which has to be soldered from the top. The wires are supplied, but always remember that you will have to solder the wire before soldering any of the components, so that you don't have any problems while soldering the other components. It will be easy for you to solder. Okay, so first let's mount the receiver board onto the chassis. So we need these four ET spacers. What do I do is I have some of the holes here. I need not connect all the four ET spacers, only we'll have to mount it on the front part of your chassis. So I'll just see which is aligned here. Any of the holes are being aligned, and I'll just choose those holes where alignment is there. So only for those holes I'll put these spaces. So these three holes are getting aligned. The front 1, 2, 1, 2, and 3 holes are getting aligned. So let me put 3 ET spaces onto this. I have to hold it like this from the bottom and put a screw from the top. Use a screwdriver and tighten the screw. Okay, so I have put 3 of the spaces, which is more than enough to balance this board under the top. So it's getting aligned with 3 of the holes here. Okay, so it is done. And from the bottom, you'll have to put these nuts. So, okay, so the board has been mounted. Here on the board, you can see near the L2390 IC, you can see there are four connectors. We'll connect the motors. As of now, we'll not worry about the direction of the motors or which motor to connect to which place. We'll just randomly insert the motor. And then finally, when we check if it is working, then we can interchange the wires and calibrate it for the different directions just by interchanging these wires. Okay, so these wires are done. It's as simple as that. You can also pass these wires through the bottom, through these grooves present on the top of the chassis. Next is the battery connections. I'll insert all the batteries. Always use a fully charged batteries so that your robot will work in good performance. You can also use rechargeable cells or any other alternative 12 volt source. If you have, you can put these connectors. If you are good enough with that, you can customizing it can also be done. So I'll place the battery set inside, and here this part, if you can see, there's a small white connector, and we'll have to just do the connections of this white connector, battery connection into it. The connector sits in only one direction, so there is no issues with that. So if you interchange also, the polarity will not change. This is the antenna. I can just lift it up and make it straight. So your robot receiver assembly is done. We'll go ahead with the transmitter joystick part. The joystick, you would have received a small cable like this with the button connector. I'll just do the connection of this here. Okay, so I'll take a 9 volts battery. Insert the cell. Okay. So that's it. Your assembly is almost done. We'll just see if it is working properly, and we'll finish this one. I'll have to switch on the transmitter. I'll have to switch on the receiver. And if you can see on the receiver, there are two LEDs here and here. So one of them, LED 1 is a power LED, and LED 2 is the reception LED. So if there is a reception from the transmitter, only then the LED glows. I'll switch off this transmitter. You can see that LED 2 goes off. So only when there is a reception, you get that LED. So even if the channel changes, there won't be a good reception. I'll just change one of the channel. See, it goes off. So always check that the power LED is on, so you know that the battery is connected, and when there is a good communication, even the LED 2 will be on. So let me check if it is working. I'll just put the joystick forward. Okay, so the forward is taking a right turn, backward is taking a left turn, and there's a change in direction. So what is the solution? It is pretty simple. We don't have to worry about that. We'll just hold the robot up, okay, and we'll just push forward, and we'll just see which wheel is rotating forward or backward. I'll just put two markers here so that you can, it is visible in the video which direction is the wheels rotating. Okay, so I'll push this front. Okay, so your wheel on the right side is going forward, but wheel on the left side is going backward when you press front. So both the wheels should be rotating forward. So what I'll do, I'll just track this wire which is going to the left wheel, which is rotating backwards. Just I'll interchange the polarities there. I'll just change the cables from here to here and here to here. Okay, so I'll push forward. Okay, so both the wheels are going forward now. I'll push backward. Both the wheels are going backward. Great. Push left. Turning left and right is done. Okay, so we'll just put it on the floor and check how it works. So we have the robot on the floor, it is ready. So we have a good distance. I have the remote over here. Let me focus it. You can see that. Let me push it front. Okay, I can't have both the focus together. Let me zoom it out. So here, let me push it front. In front, I have it back, right and left. So, and make sure even the transmitter battery is always full. It's done. We have done with the building the joystick robot. So build the robot, have fun.